Welcome back to 100 Hours of Terraria. This is Hour 7. I haven't really touched the game in a week. I've had a pretty long, rough, busy week, so I really wasn't able to play it. But now it's my day off again, so I'm going to pick up where I left off, which, last time I played, I basically got my ass handed to me by a freaking goblin army. Alright, so I just realized that was a slight mistake. I was briefly playing with a friend of mine this morning, and when I was playing, I basically was playing with a different character that I had just created so I could play with her. So, now I have to find the right character. Yep, there we go, the right character. Like I was saying, last time I played, basically got my ass handed to me by dealing with a goblin army. They killed every NPC I had except for three. That was not fun. I dislike the goblin army. I was definitely ill-prepared for it. Probably could have taken on the Eye of Cthulhu. That's what I was hoping for. Didn't quite work out that way. I might actually have to get creative for the Eye of Cthulhu, though. And by creative, I mean I might actually have to make some glasses. I'm sorry, not the glasses. What's it called? The angry eye? The annoying eye? I don't know. I just made one earlier on the other game. But I might have to do that on this one. I'll just have to remember where I left a demon altar. If I can remember where a demon altar is, then I should easily be able to make one. Yep, that's a demon altar. I just wonder if there was another one closer to the surface. I'm guessing not. Alright, so I guess that is now my target. That spot down there and right there. I hope it doesn't take too long for my NPCs to come back. I just lost way too many of them. It's kind of sad. Thank you. Turns out I didn't have to go too far. Suspicious looking eye. There you go. That's what it was. Sometimes it's easy to get those things confused. I got an idea. No doubt that I'm going to need to find this again later. I've done this once before. Bunch of torches will be somewhat easy to see on that. That should work. Immediate goal should be. Certainly a few things that I could try to accomplish right now. I don't know. Can't go after Cthulhu until nighttime. I guess I could always explore some of this area. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. Torches. Fishing here might not be productive. I don't care, I'm just getting up and down with these slimes. I got no torches. Yeah. Seem to be running out of them things pretty quickly. Okay, there's 10. One of these spots is somewhere. There we go. Silver right there. I'm guessing that's what I'll do. I will come down here and mine over to the left. Oh, that would definitely be worth going over to. Sometimes the smart cursor's a pain in the ass. You don't always realize it until something stupid like that happens either. So I only have 10 armor. I have at least 3 levels immediate that I could jump up. Lead, silver, or gold. I could see this might take a little while. Some of the resources aren't as abundant yet as I would like. Few things that I want to do besides that. I have yet to find a grappling hook yet. Thank you. partially full. Partially. I will be now, though. This is going to have to wait. First, we're gonna hit this one. Climbing claws and shoe spikes, very nice. We'll just leave that there. Pull out the arrows. Anything that I don't immediately need. Just gonna stuff in here for the moment. Take the chest with me. That is definitely going with me. This can stay. That can stay. All right. Silt, possibly some there, spider webs, boulder trap. Yeah. would be a good place for a campfire temporarily. I guess the goal I'm still working on right now, obviously, is better equipment. I need better armor and better weapons. This silver is definitely going to help a long way towards that. Should actually give me quite a bit of ore. Can't wait to get to the surface and see what it gives me. Thank you. 110 silver. Not bad. Not bad at all. Tin, some active stone blocks. Won't be able to use them for a while, but it's nice to have some of them around. Alright, I guess I'm gonna take a trip back to the surface. Yeah. Loot what I can carry. Second here. Alrighty. I think my one friend is a lot better at managing these things than I am. She certainly finds better places for stuff most of the time than I do. That's not to say I'm terrible at it, but she's just a bit more organized. Nothing wrong with that. And I can't do. I can do a little organization. It's not hard. But I got so much junk right now. I'll find a place for everything. Let me check in with the guide real quick. Topaz hook. Okay. 15 topaz. And it requires an anvil. Perfect. Looks like I might have my first grappling hook. not exactly the best, but it is way better than nothing. One thing that escapes me right now that I definitely want to get is the GPS. I forget exactly how to make it. Five solar bars, very nice. That was... what was I creating? Yes, I was making the lead set earlier. Yeah, it's quite unfortunate that I just don't have enough to really do a whole lot. Lead axe, tin hammer. Could definitely use a new hammer. Yep. I'll go with the silver hammer. Speak to the guide again. Chests. Glass kiln, and I have not made one of these things yet. Pretty sure it opens up a lot of different stuff. Definitely something I'm gonna have to check out. Able to do that earlier. I guess it requires active time to be able to do something like that. Some flaming arrows too. really sad that the bars still can't stack past 99. I got no more wood in my inventory. I think I need to go visit my tree farm. That's more than enough. I still got two rooms that are missing people. I should say. Kind of hard to pass off with free slime. Give me some gel. There we go. This is a relatively small tree farm, but it works. I can always expand it later too. 156 wood's not bad. Mini shark. I love mini sharks. It's usually one of the first things I try to buy. Sucker for dynamite and bombs. They come in handy. So far, those are clear right there. Stone, ebon stone, spiky block. Alright. I got silt around here somewhere. I know I picked it up. Not gonna find it. There we go. Wow. That is quite a bit of silt. Now, silt is really good. Same thing with slush blocks. Once you have an extractinator, which I just got, you can feed them into it. You get money. Various ores. From what I understand, if you're really lucky, you get a piece of amber, I think a fossilized mosquito, that actually gives you a dinosaur pet. I have not been lucky enough to get this thing yet. I'm just going to start putting it in there. Lots of ore. Lots and lots of ore. I'm seeing a lot of coins. The one other good thing about this is that you can actually get the standard ores that don't come in the world, that don't spawn in the world naturally. So, whereas I got tin in this world naturally, you see copper ores popping up in here. So this is actually a good way to get the other standard ores, rather than actually going into a different world and farming everything. 81 silver coins, 62 copper coins from that. 4 copper ore. 14 iron, 17 silver, 11 lead, 15 tin, 12 gold, 9 platinum, 12 tungsten, 3 regular ambers, 3 emerald, 2 sapphire, a diamond. That's pretty nice right there. I mean, a lot of these things, like I said, some of these ores aren't going to occur naturally in my world, but I can actually obtain them this way. It's very useful. And I can just smelt down anything I need. Some of these things didn't exactly have the room for. Not a big deal. Alright, quick stack that. Actually have enough lead for the boots. Yep, lead greaves. I'll do the silver chest while I'm at it. Gonna end up taking these off since I can actually equip them now. Start putting random materials over here. Organized, but this right now definitely needs to just throw some stuff in. call it a day. Alright. My inventory is about as organized as it's going to get this minute. So this is an end to hour 7. Stay tuned for hour